adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
運輸及房屋
Secretary for Transport and Housing. Mr. President, I move the second reading of the Road Traffic Legislation Parking Spaces Amendment Bill 2019. The object of the bill is to provide the legal basis for the operation of a new generation of parking meters with additional features to cater for motorists' short-term parking needs. The government currently provides some 9,700 parking meters, covering about 18,000 on-street parking spaces in the territory. In her 2017 policy address, the chief executive announced that as one of the smart mobility initiatives, the government would install a new generation of on-street parking meters, which would replace the existing meters that have been in use since 2003-04 and are approaching the end of their serviceable life. The existing parking meters only accept payment of parking fees by Octopus Card. To enhance the operational efficiency and to facilitate motorists, the new generation of parking meters will accept payment via multiple electronic means and support the purchase of additional parking time by remote payment through a mobile application. Given the rapid development of electronic payment means and to allow flexibility for consideration of adoption of emerging payment means in the future, the bill empowers the Commissioner for Transport to approve new payment means, including mobile payment for collecting parking fees by new meters and the approved arrangements will be published through general notices in the Gazette. To facilitate motorists identify available on-street parking spaces, each new parking meter will be accompanied with vehicle sensors to detect whether the relevant space is occupied. The sensors, however, will not collect any personal data or vehicle identification numbers. Real-time parking vacancy information will be disseminated to the public through the Transport Department's mobile application, Hong Kong e-mobility, and the website. The bill provides the Commissioner for Transport with the power to detect the occupancy of the parking spaces through vehicle sensors. It also stipulates that anyone who interferes with a parking meter, including the sensor, commits an offence. New parking meters will no longer be standalone on-street fee-collecting devices, but will form an integral system, including the back-end systems. To protect the parking meter system from interference, the bill provides for a new offence relating to unauthorized access to the data or information contained in a parking meter, including its back-end systems, and attempts to tamper with such data or information. As electronic payment systems gain traction, the government has no plan to accept cash payment or e-park cards again for use of metered on-street parking spaces. As such, we will take this opportunity through the bill to repeal outdated provisions pertaining to using cash and parking cards for parking fee payment. From 2015 to early 2018, the Transport Department conducted a new parking meter system trial scheme to assess the technical feasibility and public acceptance of the potential new features and functions, as well as electronic payments to be incorporated in the new generation of parking meters. The parking meters performed stably and smoothly during the trial periods, and members of the public generally supported the new features and functions. We consulted the Electrical Panel for Transport in January 2018 on the functions of new parking meters, the procurement arrangements, as well as adjusting the maximum fee. Members in general supported replacing the existing meters and the proposed functions of the new parking meters. As for the proposed maximum fee for use of on-street parking space, it has not been adjusted since 1994. We originally proposed to increase the fee level to increase the turnover rate of on-street metered parking spaces. However, in the light of the recent economic and social situation in Hong Kong and the panel's views, we've proactively revisited the proposed increase in maximum fee. To avoid increasing the financial burden of motorists in the transport trades, the government has decided to withhold the proposed increase. Hence, no amendment will be made in relation to this under the bill. Details of the proposal are set out in the electoral brief issued to members on the 13th of November. I urge members to support the early passage of the bill so that the government can complete the installation of new parking meters in around 2 years, starting from the first half of 2020. The administration will fully cooperate with the council's scrutiny of the bill. Mr. President, I so submit. I now propose a question to you, and that is that the aforesaid bill be read the second time. In accordance with the rules of procedure, the second reading debate is adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
本會在2019